More now on Singapore's $800 million package to support companies and workers hit by the latest tightening of COVID-19 restrictions. F&B outlets are welcoming the extra help, and they say it's a relief the tougher measures are working with no further tightening expected for now. Tan Sehui has more.
Shutters down, chairs stacked, and tables set aside. This restaurant that offers Taiwanese food and bubble tea at McCallum Street will be shut until dine-in is allowed to resume.
So this is actually our kitchen area. You can see it's quite empty now because we have shifted most of our equipment over to the new temporary kitchen.
A stark contrast compared to December 2019, when the restaurant opened with much fanfare. The latest restrictions are a further setback after last year's circuit breaker. And having to pay a five-digit rental fee, it's a struggle.
The business actually slipped more than 50%. This is largely because of the decrease in the footfall in the CBD area. And then with a lot of people working from home, purely by delivery and takeaway, it's very hard to sustain the business.
But there's hope. With the recent announcements, there will be a half-month rental relief cash payout for privately owned commercial properties. It will be disbursed from mid-August directly to qualifying tenants as part of a new rental support scheme. Mr. Chang says it's a good move as tenants like himself won't have to wait for landlords to make a decision.
We are definitely very grateful and encouraged by this package to help us to tie off this period. But what we really hope for is that the community cases could ease down by 13th of June, and then we could resume dine-in as soon as possible after that.
The new measures are set to benefit not only the Taiwan food industry, but also many food outlets that are struggling. If you take a short walk in the surrounding area, you can see that many shops have their shutters pulled down, and it's unusually quiet on a Friday evening. According to a poll by Singapore Tenants United for Fairness, more than 80% of businesses across retail and F&B services are experiencing a sales drop of more than half with the latest set of restrictions. About 40% are planning to shut most of their shops and lay off staff.
Rebates for the rental, once again, small, but better than nothing. I think that's a good sign. But I guess the largest walk away from all the reports is that Minister Lawrence Wong actually mentioned that there's no need to tighten and the measures are working. I think that would really boost our confidence quite a bit.
While the incentives are helpful, Mr. Ng adds it's more sustainable for businesses to adapt and adjust in a volatile environment. Meantime, hawkers are getting a leg up. They will pay 50% stall rental in May and June. 71-year-old Sim Mong Soon and his wife are owners of this drink stall at Whampoa Hawker Centre. They've been here since the 70s and say it's the worst crisis they've experienced.
Normally, we will order every week maybe 4 or 5 crates, but now no. Now maybe I think less than a crate or maybe worse or sometimes.
Facebook groups like Hawkers United have provided a platform to advertise their food and allow customers to do group orders. But elderly hawkers like Mr. Sim aren't turning to these platforms. So they rely heavily on loyal customers, since drinks may not always be on the menu compared to cooked food. Even so, he sees his glass half full.
Yes, continue lah. After our age is catching up, we are no more young, right? Stay here until the day, no, we are caught up.